Greetings and welcome to this service of worship and this celebration of commencement. In our theological tradition, we believe that the Holy Spirit calls us into service. And this celebration is one affirmation of that call and the beginning of another. Today, we gather together to affirm our graduates and to thank their families for investing in them. And we gather to affirm the hard work and commitment of all of those who've dedicated their lives to learning in service to the church and to the world. So let us celebrate today together, because this is the day which the Lord has made. So let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen.
Please join me for the call to worship, which you'll see right here. You know what time it is, how it is now the moment to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we first became believers. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day and put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh to gratify its desires. Join me in prayer. Holy Three in One, maker of heaven and earth and lover of our souls, we come before you in humble adoration of your many works. By your word, you spoke into existence the billions of stars in billions of galaxies. You filled this blessed planet with an abundance of life, creatures of sea and land and sky. By your word and the breath of your mouth, you formed us out of the dirt to share in your reign of peace upon the earth. By your word, you made us a little lower than the angels and crowned us with glory and honor. In our pride, it was not enough for us, and we grasped for control. We inherited death. In times like these, we are so aware that we are like grass that withers and fades away. Our life is fragile and fleeting. And yet your word stands forever, secure at all times, undaunted by famine or plague. It is in your gracious word to us that we trust. It was your word made flesh in the person of Jesus Christ that opened up the way for us back to eternal life, life abundant. In this time when we are so aware of our frailty, so conscious of the precarity of our lives, we look to your word for hope. We entrust our lives to you, who created life and defeated death. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil why we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, come, invade us now. We are your church. We need your power in us. We seek your kingdom first. We hunger and we thirst. Refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released, the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace. We lay down our lives for heaven's cause. We are your church, and we pray revive this earth. Build your kingdom here, let the darkness fear. Show your church on fire. Witness nation change the atmosphere, build your kingdom here, we pray. Unleash your kingdom's power, reaching near and far, no force of hell can stop your beauty changing hearts. You made us for much more than this. Awake the kingdom's seed in us. Fill us with the strength and love of Christ. We are your church. We are the hope on earth.
Let us pray. O Lord, give us ears that we might hear, and eyes that we might see what you have for us in your holy word this day. And then give us the will to follow where you lead. In Jesus' name, amen. Our scripture this morning is taken from the Gospel of John, chapter 15, verses 12 through 17. Let us listen for God's word. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. This is not what we were expecting for graduation this year, is it? We expected to gather to celebrate our academic and personal achievements with family and friends all around us. We expected laughter and tears of joy and relief, last hugs from colleagues with whom we have journeyed through thick and thin over the last several years, and to whom we are now bound as brothers and sisters. We expected to worship face to face and stand shoulder to shoulder in line to receive our diplomas, to mingle afterward, introducing spouses and parents and grandparents to our classmates. This is not what we expected. gathering with only immediate family around a computer screen, receiving that diploma via the U.S. mail, preaching to an empty room. Our scripture this morning reminds us, however, that we are not alone as we endure this pandemic with its illness, death, and social distancing. Jesus reminds us that despite the staggering statistics of disease and of death that may be intruding in our lives, and despite the disappointments and isolation that we are experiencing, we have not been abandoned. As Easter affirms, even in the midst of our sorrow and our grief, Jesus is among us. Jesus has chosen us to be his friend. And a friend is marked not only by the willingness to do all in one's power for our well-being, even to death on a cross, but a friend never leaves us. Jesus, who is Emmanuel, God with us, promises he will remain with us no matter what. So what does that mean for us today? Well, for one, it banishes the fear that we have been left to suffer these trials alone. It means that we can trust in the words of Julian of Norwich, "All shall be well. All shall be well. All manner of things shall be well, because we are in the hands of a God who loves and cherishes us." It means that even if we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we will not fear evil. For one who walks beside us, before whom the very demons tremble, and whose name they take flight, will not leave us alone. We have only to call upon the name of Jesus, and his Spirit can banish our anxieties, strengthen our wavering hearts, and enable us to rest in the confidence of his steadfast love. It also means that we have been friended by Jesus for a purpose, that we should go and friend others. We have been loved that we can love others. We have been given spiritual resources to reach out to a troubled and despairing world and do as Jesus would do. Bring healing balm to the sick, comfort to the dying, stand with the suffering. While we may have to do so from a distance for the time being, we can still practice those gifts of friendship that Jesus modeled for us: patience, encouragement, presence. Even as we reach out to Jesus for the wisdom and the strength to minister to others, we must reach out to those especially in need of his love, of his hope, of his blessing. We must reach out to those who know not a Savior who loves them and overcame death that we may live. We must extend the invitation that has been extended to us to rest in the belovedness of God. This is what it means to bear fruit, trusting the outcome to the Lord of the harvest. This is the holy calling that we have received. This is the privilege that we have been given to participate with the triune God in reconciling the world to God. Friendship, writes Dana Robert, carries in its core the joy of resurrection. As we have experienced the transformative power and new life of the risen Lord, Christ in us, the hope of glory, so we now witness to those he puts in our path, to the amazing joy that he offers his friends. Now, forced to shelter in place, we have the time to shelter under the wings of God, to rest in the presence of the Holy One, that we can better bring to those around us, through whatever means available to us, that same peace, hope, love, and joy that Christ offers to all whom he calls his friends. C.S. Lewis, in The Four Loves, echoes the words of Antoine de Saint-Exupéry, author of The Little Prince, who wrote, "Love does not consist of gazing at each other, but in looking outward in the same direction." We have the opportunity to be present to Jesus in new ways as we hunker down in social isolation. We also have the opportunity to minister in new ways to those in our care, to those who have been entrusted to us to befriend. Will we take advantage of our friendship with Jesus to come alongside others, stand in friendship with them, and together direct our eyes upon Jesus, our rock and our Redeemer? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer.
Every year, the seminary recognizes outstanding gifts for ministry by awarding prizes to members of the student body. These awards were announced last night at the awards premiere and are noted on the back of the commencement program available on the UD website. Additionally, Dr. Beth McCaw, Associate Professor of Ministry, was granted the William L. Lomax Award for Excellence in Teaching and Advising earlier this semester. Please join me in congratulating these individuals for their significant accomplishments.
Good morning to all of you. I am pleased to be joining you today in this virtual graduation ceremony during this unique period in our lives. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I am pleased to join in celebrating your academic achievements. As you are recognized for your certificates and degrees, have confidence that you have been equipped for ministry. You join the faithful community of University of Dubuque Theological Seminary alumni who are serving God's people across the nation and around the world. We wish God's blessings on you, our graduates. May you experience much success as you seek to follow God's call.
The following have received the Certificate in Christian Leadership for Commissioned Ruling Elders. Faith C. Heraut, Carl G. Martin, Leslie Manhart Manconi, Catherine Rosen, Lucy Scarborough, Robert Glenn Scarborough, Crystal Weber. The following are the candidates for degrees in
Master of Arts in Christian Leadership, Master of Arts in Mission and Discipleship, Master of Divinity, Joshua Botts, Richard Purcell, Michelle Shireschmidt, Nick Walwork, Tila Creekmore, Kayla Schween, Nate Amarke, Logan Ellis, Rebecca Higman, Hillary Islin Thomas, Keith Pitts, Cheryl Puderbaugh, Holly Samborski, Sibele Santos, Frank Shepard Jr., Melinda Stonebreaker, Calvin Sidnor IV, Joanna Sidnor, Lana Williams.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you with all of its rights and privileges the degree of Master of Arts in Christian Leadership, Master of Arts in Mission and Discipleships, and Master of Divinity. As president and on behalf of the board and your faculty, I pray that God will bless you in your service to others and to Jesus Christ.
Doctor of Ministry. Benjamin Song Boy. Whitney Dempsey. Sydney B. Miller.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I hereby confer upon you with all of its rights and privileges the degree of Doctor of Ministry.
Congratulations, UDTS Class of 2020. Woo!
Sisters and brothers who are graduating among us today, you receive two symbols of your accomplishments and God's faithfulness and the community in which you have been formed and prepared. The first is your hood. You may have that here with you as we are gathered here in the spirit. And if so, let me tell you a little bit about what it represents. This hood represents the graduate work that you have completed and the degree that you've received. But of special interest along the edge, we have the trimming that is scarlet, and this represents the field of theology. In addition to that, we have our school colors here. So when you prepare to put on your hood, you'll want to have the triangle here and have the colors well displayed. And then there's a little tag to affix it when you put it on so that it stays put. And perhaps you have your hood now and would like to put it on, or someone is there with you who would hood you. And in that case, I will model that as I hood Nikki here. The second symbol you're receiving is the Lindsay Cross, and this also our graduates should have received in their graduation boxes. And as we prepare to put that on and to pray, hear a little bit about what is represented in it. It is a symbol of the office of the dean at the University of Dubuque Theological Seminary, and it is a replica of the original Lindsay Cross, which is in Guy Chapel on campus. Edwin B. Lindsay was an elder at First Presbyterian Church in Davenport, Iowa. And he was a longtime chair and member of the Board of Trustees for the University of Dubuque. It's a Celtic cross, which has a long history in Ireland and in Scotland, and it symbolizes the redeeming work of Christ and also the Christocentric emphasis we have here at Dubuque Seminary. You'll see on it the circle, which reminds us of eternity, and the vine and the branches, reminding us that we are the branches that abide in the vine, who is Jesus Christ. So as we prepare to put these on and pray, recommit yourself to listen and look for signs of the Holy Spirit and the journey ahead of you to abide in Christ, who is our vine and who nourishes us. Continue to be formed into the image of Christ, and to walk in the Spirit as you use the gifts of the Spirit. Minister to your family as your first congregation among other circles of call. Make your work your worship, and trust in the steadfast love and grace of Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Savior. Let's put on our crosses and pray. O Lord, uphold these graduates by your Holy Spirit. Daily increase in them your gifts of grace, that they may be faithful in service to you both now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, in every age you have chosen servants to speak your word and lead your people. We thank you for these graduates whom you have called to serve you. Grant them the gifts to fulfill their callings and fill them with your Holy Spirit, that they may have the same mind that was in Christ Jesus. God of grace, you call us to a common ministry as ambassadors of Christ, trusting us with the message of reconciliation. Give us courage and discipline to follow you, that together we may declare your wonderful deeds and show your love to the world through Jesus Christ, the Lord of all, who taught us when we pray to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Darkest nights, when my hopes have failed, you will be my shining light.
And now go out and serve the world with energy, imagination, intelligence, and love. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you and abide within you each one, now and forevermore. And all God's people said, Amen.
Congratulations, UDTS class of 2020. Woo!
Hallelujah.